What's up, guys? I want to take time to talk about spreading the floor or screwing your feet into the ground. So I think this is a really important concept, not only for lifting, but also for throwing. So what do we mean when we say spread the floor or corkscrew the ground or, you know, try to counter-rotate the feet? Really what we're getting at is think about setting up for a squat, right? If I'm set up for a squat, my feet are going to be facing slightly out. And what I want to think about doing is I want to think about putting force into the ground. And without actually moving my feet outside, I want to actually just think about twisting my feet into the ground. Like imagine you have a nail in the bottom of your foot that's going straight into the ground, and you're trying just to screw that nail into the ground as much as you can. And what you're going to find is when you do that, you're going to feel tension and torque be created all the way up your legs, okay? So you can almost even see with my legs. Right now I'm nice and relaxed. Now I've created that tension, and it's going to naturally make me want to externally rotate a little bit more. And now when I do that, if I'm doing a squat, for example, now I'm going to have more stability. I'm not going to be as likely to have these knees waver and go inside like some people do. I'm going to have a lot of tension created, and it's going to be a very stable base for me to now drive when I do a squat. When I'm throwing, I'm trying to do the same thing, right? So like if I'm throwing this way, I'm left-handed, I want to think about this back foot being screwed into the rubber. And now I have this back leg is strong. This back leg is strong, and it's ready to produce some force into the ground. Versus if I'm just really loose with this back leg and there isn't a lot of stability, like there's really not going to be a lot of force going into the ground. So that's just one little thing you can do as you're throwing, is to just preset that torque a little bit and really think about screwing that back foot into the ground. And now I'm strong and stable and I'm ready to go and throw. All right, so give that a try in your next bullpen or plyo drill or whatever it is. And I think you're going to really feel a difference in that tension created in that back leg.